Hey, friends. Welcome back to Dr. Pastor
friends.
JP.
That's a
We're all friends.
Friends. Reminds me of...
I'll be there for you.
No, Barney.
Oh, okay. Well, anyway, Dr. Pastor JP reacts. If you're new to our channel, Dr. Pastor JP, I'm Pastor Caleb. And we've been doing react videos for quite a few months now. It's been a little while. Did the NF journey.
Yep.
Done some other people. We're going through some Dax songs right now, which has been fun and exciting. And we're going to react to another Dax song called Child of God.
Dear God, thank you for leading me down this path. I'm thankful for the man that I am. At first, I didn't understand. Now I see the tribulations that I faced were all part of the plan. I tried to walk away, I wasn't whole. You fill the gap inside my heart and let me know I had a soul. I was bleeding on the inside, nobody could see. Then I looked into the mirror, he was staring back at me. Now I gotta say, I was lost, where'd I go? Now I'm here, glory road, child of God, not a sheep. Lost my way, came on home. Used to think the world was cold and I was fighting all alone. Until I made that call and heard his voice and touch right through that phone. All my pain, all my stress, added to the dumb neglect. I used to take my burdens and disperse them around to all my friends. Anger and frustration was a means, but never to an end. Until you picked me up and took that weight right up off my chest. The child of God, nothing more, nothing less. Born sinner, not by choice, but also born blessed. I could feel the pressure building up and choking at my neck. Then God told me take a breath and he would handle all the rest. I'm not a stranger to evil, I've done wrong to people. I've told lies, but in his eyes I am still equal. My words weaponized, bars save lives, they lethal and take off in the sky. Spread wings like eagles, my life's an open book, something for the world to see. People watching what I do, so I'm careful of words I speak. Came up as a child, I never thought that this was what I'd be. But now that it's my path, I swear to God that I won't fail to lead. Speaking positivity with every...
I think it's interesting compared to the other songs where it's a lot of... The other songs seem to be a lot of crying out, a lot of uncertainty.
Yeah.
This one's a lot more certain. It seems a lot more like...
Definitely more certain.
I am a child. I know where I'm going.
Yep.
I know what I'm doing.
Yep.
I screwed up.
Yep.
But Christ isn't, you know?
Yep. One thing I was wondering, he said he picked up the phone and dialed God. I was wondering what the phone number was.
Yeah, I would like that number too.
Like, I've got some questions. I use that sometimes. But yeah, I get it. I get what he's saying.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah. So, I mean, I think it's good thus far. We'll see.
Let's just finish it out. Yeah, that's a quick one.
Watching what I do, so I'm careful of words I speak. Came up as a child, I never thought that this was what I'd be. But now that it's my path, I swear to God that I won't fail to lead. Speaking positivity with every single breath I breathe. Looking up to God, I'm on my hands and down on my knees. Asking him to grant me with the strength in this world of greed. To be the person that will have a shoulder when they need to lean. Promises I made to you, God, yes I will keep. May not be who they want, but I'm making what they need. Rose from the dirt in the middle of the concrete and bloom to a tree. Create and disperse seeds. Impact is what I bleed. Won't fall for anything. I answer to God. I don't answer to no human being. I am not a slave. I am not the devil nor a fiend. I'm a child of God just like you. We on the same team. Grab my hand. Stand up. I won't leave you. You need me just as much as I need you. Fight these battles with me. I promise that you will see through.
See the guy in the orange? Remember him.
Child of God. He is I and you are him. To see God, we must first look within. Nowhere else, no place, no human, no race, just us and faith till we meet again. It's Dax. We're all created in God's image. Each and every single one of us. Spread love. Receive love. Have faith. Amen.
Okay, so it is good. It's very good. So just comical, just something that I picked up watching it. If those were supposed to be, or those the people that were following Jesus, like Jesus followers back in the day?
I think so, yeah.
Okay, look at the guy in the orange.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen a blonde-haired, blue-eyed Jew?
Or
Jewish person?
Or
I mean, I'm not trying to be disrespectful at all. I'm really not, but I'm like, okay, that's... don't know.
It's funny. Yeah.
Actually, you know what it looks like a little bit?
What?
The painting of the Lord's Supper.
Yeah.
Which I think it's
so
interesting.
Speaking of the Lord's Supper or the last dinner.
The Last Supper.
The Last Supper. I saw a quote that said Jesus sat at people's tables, invited people to his tables,
yes,
and flipped tables. And yes, we need to do all three. And like I just kind of the imagery there of the Last Supper and everybody, yeah, sitting at the same table with Jesus.
And maybe they're like, trying to I don't know, maybe the video's, I don't know. It's his interpretation. I think it's good.
I like it.
But I was just thinking of that. I'm, yeah, like, wow, he doesn't look like a guy that would, yeah,
I don't know. So I do have
a question. Not trying to be critical or, yeah, disrespectful.
Go ahead,
at all.
Dalton. I do have a question because I think it's kind of interesting. Most of the song is pretty straightforward, pretty, mm-hmm, whatever. There is something he says here at the end that I'm curious what you think about. Forget exactly where.
Do ask.
I'm just going to replay this little ending part.
Okay.
And see if you catch it. Beneath you, child of God, he is I, and you are him. To see God, we must first look within. Nowhere else, no place, no human, no race, just us and faith till we meet again. It's Dax. He is I and I am him, or you are him. Is that
and
what you're
you,
talking about?
To find him first, you have to look within.
Yeah. I'm not sure exactly what he's going for there, but I'm curious what you think about it.
You can get in trouble with this. There was a mega church pastor that, I'm not going to name names, but said, I am God, and people lit him up. I think what I interpret he's trying to say is we are not God. I am not God. You are not God that I know of.
We are created in the image of God.
We are created in the image of God. And I think the idea is we're supposed to represent God everywhere we go. That's how I would kind of interpret that. That I am God, you are God, and he is, like, that whole statement. I would kind of hope that he's trying to say you're a representation of God, not I'm God.
If that's what he's trying to say, then I would say, yeah. If we're made in God's image, that was what he...
That's what it started with, yeah.
That's what it started with. If we're made in God's image, then I think the premise of the video is that we should bear his image well.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I think he's trying to say.
I agree.
Which I agree with. I agree with that. And I agree with the end statement that I think that's a path. Like, he's trying to get across, that's a path. Like, you have to look at yourself. Are you... Mm-hmm. Are you displaying that image well?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, but as far as saying, I don't think he's saying that we're all gods. Yeah. I don't think he's saying that. I don't believe that.
I don't believe that at all. Because we talked about this in the last
video. Bible's clear on that.
Isaiah 64, yeah, we're all filthy rags.
Yeah, the Bible's clear. Yeah. Do we bear God's image? Yes.
Yeah. Well, and there's, I don't know the verse, we're ambassadors.
Yes.
So
representatives.
We're representatives of Christ.
That's what an image bearer does.
Can you imagine? So, like, pretty much what he's saying is love each other. Love everyone. Be ambassadors.
Which we would absolutely agree with 100%.
And we kind of bashed the church in the last video. If you didn't see it, check it out. But can you imagine if the church, Christians as a whole, just understood this concept? Just love each other.
Can I take that back a little bit further?
Yeah.
Can you imagine a church that was just simply kind?
Yeah. That would be incredible.
Just be kind.
Just be kind. Yeah.
Be nice to one another. Stop biting and devouring one another. Be, mm-hmm, kind. And we all struggle. We can all struggle. Well,
and
that.
that's why we have different denominations.
You want to impact the world around you? Be kind. Just be nice.
I made shirts for something last summer. We were giving them out, and it says, you want to change the world? And then on the back, it says, for God so loved the world. You got to love. You want to change the world, love the world.
Yeah.
And like, just as Christians as a whole, we have done a terrible job of showing love. We are so quick to bash and hate.
The path to loving.
You're wrong, and I'm right.
You know, the path to loving is generated in us by... You know what God wants for us, right? He wants us to love one another. The Apostle Paul says, "If you walk in step with my spirit, then you're going to produce love." but the pathway to love is practicing kindness first. Mm-hmm. Like you can't love something just, well, I'm just going to love them out of, well, okay. Then I ask, okay, is that genuine?
Yeah.
Or are you just doing it because that's what you're told to do? Do you really love me or not? I mean, I'm sure people have their, you know, our viewers right. might have the question.
Right. Right.
You're just doing that because you don't really love me. You're doing it because it's self-serving. And that's not what, I don't think that's what the premise of this video. And that's not what God would say.
Yeah.
He doesn't want it to be self. He does genuinely want us to love one another. But how do we do that? And we do that by the path of beginning with, hey, I'm going to be kind to you. You be kind to me. We develop mm-hmm. a relationship. I get to know you. Or maybe I don't get to know you. And out of the compassion of my heart,
yeah,
I love you and care for you at the degree I can, at the level that I can. Well, I'm going to feed you. I'm going to clothe you. I'm going to do what I can. But not out of the self-serving attitude yeah. or
just read the book of Ephesians. The whole yes. book is here's how to love your boss. Here's how to love your yeah. spouse. Here's how to love your kids. Like
yeah.
the, yeah, I think the whole premise here is just,
I do not believe he's saying that we are gods.
I don't either.
I think he's saying, to find God, you have to look within like that. That's part of it. Like find him as you're walking with him. You find him inside. Look at yourself. Are you representing it well?
Obviously, he's talking about being kind, and we have this picture of him mm-hmm. Here at the end with everyone else, and they're all being nice to each other. But then there's like this imagery of him carrying the cross with Jesus. What do you think right. of that and how that applies?
Well, there was a person who was pulled out of the crowd to help bear the cross of mm-hmm. Jesus. And so that's not that really so much out of the realm of
no, that's
believability.
Well, in even in take up your cross and follow him. So the idea of dying to yourself daily and carrying our cross.
Here's the thing, you know, okay, now you asked. You asked. So there was this guy that Jesus was struggling carrying the cross. He'd been beaten, mm-hmm. whipped, flogged, mistreated,
beard ripped out of his face.
I mean, just no energy, no strength, and he couldn't carry the cross. So this mm-hmm. guy was pulled out of the crowd as he was making his way to that hill where mm-hmm. he was ultimately going to be crucified. And this, he pulled this guy out of the crowd and said, "Hey, you carry Jesus's cross." Yeah. And here's the like, it's so counter. He did that, and he helped Jesus bear his load. And by Jesus dying on the cross, he actually bared the load for all mm-hmm. humanity mm. in return. Like, so this picture, I love it, quite frankly. I think, you know, because Jesus tells us, hey, if you want to follow me, mm-hmm. pick up your cross.
Take up your cross.
Take up your cross and bear it. I bore it for you. My burden is easy. You know, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. I mean, mm-hmm. and so this is a picture of kind of Christianity and kind of when I look at it and I see that, I'm like, okay, yeah, I get that.
All right. Well, check out our other videos, comment below and ask questions. If you got questions.
We're sitting here and I just received two more from our producer on my phone because he's bored.
So yeah, if you need help or you just want to talk, JP's email box is open
yep.
in the Jot form below and you get direct access to our counselor lead pastor, JP.
I will try to email the best I can. Yeah, back.
But comment your questions. And yep. pretty soon here, we're going to do a JP reacts to comments. And we're going to pick out some of our questions.
That
and comments,
makes me nervous.
And we're going to try to lovingly address your concerns and open-ended questions. Like, comment, subscribe, do all the things. Don't forget, keep your nose in the book.